Hi, my name is Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about an overview review of the graphing concepts that we've learned. So there's nothing new in this video, just a review for you. We talked about in the last video deciding which ordered pair or if any were solutions to an equation and how to find the x and y intercept of an equation. Another thing that we learned was how to find the slope of a line given two points on the line. And the formula for that is the difference of the y's over the x's. And remember, because we have two y's, we need to give them subscripts, and we have two x's, so we give them subscripts. So we're just subtracting the y's and the x's. Don't get too hung up on subscript. That's not, you know, not a big deal. We have here, we're going to call these our first and this our second point. So what I have is y sub 2, which is 1, sub 2 just means subscript 2, and then minus y sub 1, x sub 2 minus x sub 1. And then we're going to just simplify that. Negative 1 and negative 5, or minus, negative 1 minus 5 is negative 6, and 2 plus 3 is 5. So we would say our slope here is negative 6 fifths. That would be a line that falls from left to right. It's a decreasing line. All right, and the second one, if I do my y sub 2, well, let's label these. I'm a big proponent of that if you're having trouble with this at all. And the biggest thing that people make mistakes on is getting the signs wrong. So I have negative 2 minus, and I have negative 2 again, 5 minus 3. Well, negative 2 minus 2 is actually negative 2 plus 2, right? And so negative 2 plus 2 is 0 over 2. And we've seen this before. Whenever you have a slope that has a 0 in the numerator, we know that 0 divided by anything is 0. So the slope is 0. And the last thing that we've done that I want you to practice is to match equations. That is, here's an equation, and here's what they could mean. Notice there's four different equations, and there's only three things, so that we're not going to be able to match all of these. But which ones of these do have matches? And the first one, we'll start over here. He started with 5 cows and bought 25 more cows per month. I put extra sum in there just so you have to think a little bit more. So he started with 5 and bought 25 more per month. Our slope, which is next to the x here, the slope is a rate of change. That's something that's changing periodically, monthly or daily or yearly. So what is our slope here? Well, our slope is 25 because that's what's happening. He's getting 25 more cows every month. So we are knowing that he's starting with 5. Here's one. He's starting with 5, and he's gaining 25 cows per month. So I'm going to say that this one is represented, could be represented by that statement. This is an abstract concept, but I'm trying to put meaning to it so you can say, what am I looking at when I'm looking at this? You're looking at a starting point, and in this case, an increase every month. Okay, in this one, she started with 320 sheep, but sold 15 per year. So in this case, she started with 320. I see two different equations that start with 320. But she's selling 15 per year. So is her herd of sheep going up or down? Flock of sheep, sorry. Going up or down? Well, she's selling them, so it should be getting less. And so our rate of change should be negative. Here's the one that has a negative. She's starting with 320, but she's seeing a decrease in her flock by 15 per year. So it must be that this one is matched with this one. And then it becomes a little easier because they began with 25 pigs and they had 5 more were born every month. I don't know why I got into the whole farmyard thing. I'm not into that, but anyways. So she began with 25. So here's 25, her beginning, and then 5 more per month. Well, this is starting at 320, so that doesn't make any sense. She began with 25 and she gained 5 every month. So in this case, this one could be described in this way. All right, so hopefully that helps you understand a little more abstractly what's going on, a little less abstractly, I'm sorry. Should